It's time for the Family Feud, introducing the Shirley family. Bert, Travis, Michelle, Tawny, and Jeff, ready for action. And the Montaleone family, Patty, Pam, Peggy, Penny, and Polly. On your marks, let's start the Family Feud. With the star of Family Feud, Richard Dawson.
Listen, this is, I have to talk to our audience here because we're 1 hour delayed from taping, so they've probably been here, what, 2 hours? Have you?
Yeah.
So we're sorry. You know what happened? We had a camera go wrong here. And I want to give a medal to my buddy who's entertained you all this time. Yeah. Mr. Gene Woods, right there. Excellent. I really felt for you because I watched you on the monitor, you know, and you were having so much fun. And we were terrible. We were playing backgammon and gambling. We should have a good time. The champs or the Shirleys, right here. How are you, Bert?
Oh, I'm just fine. How are you?
It's lovely to see you.
Well, it's good to see you again, too.
How much money have you won, do you know?
Yes, $1,004.
That's not bad, is it?
No, it isn't bad. Hey,
I'll worry about the husband. Sure. Let's meet everybody, then we'll talk.
This is my husband, Travis, of 58 long years. Seems like 100, but it's just great. And my granddaughter-in-law, Michelle.
Hi, darling.
And my great-granddaughter, Tawny, and my great-grandson, Jeff Walter.
All righty. Nice to see you. I had that pen you gave me?
Yes. You still got it.
Bert gave me a pen that had the ash from
Mount St.
Helens, yeah, and I was
blew
right.
Blew up and blew a lot of pens out, and
it
I brought one to you.
Yeah. Has Travis given you any trouble since I saw you the last time?
Do you really want to know?
Yeah. Come on, tell me.
No, not really.
Not at all?
He says mine pretty good.
He's a sweetheart. What do we got here?
Well, I told you we'd been married 58 years, and we married in the Model T.
That's right. They got married
in
a car. You wouldn't get out the car, right?
I was too scared to get out
the car. So the preacher leaned in the window and married them.
And
that's the truth.
This is, believe it or not.
Is this it?
Yeah, that's it.
Who did this for you?
Well, a friend of mine did it for me and put the old Texas
Look at this.
License tag on.
There's Bert and Travis. And there's the preacher. See, she was too... She was scared. That was good.
Her knee was shaking.
That was... You remember his name, the preacher's name?
What was his name?
Remember Travis?
Max
right
something.
Now, I couldn't tell you.
Max,
my
Max
memory
something.
Is so bad.
Max, was it?
Mac.
McPherson.
Yeah, that's a good one.
Yeah.
That's close.
The Reverend McPherson.
Yeah, we'll say that. Make something.
Now, this audience, not only because they've waited so long,
I know.
They did not hear, because on the last show we talked about, tell them how you met Bert. How did you meet him?
Well.
I loved it. You got him. So romantic.
You know, back them days, you picked cotton in a sack. They didn't have these big machines.
Right. And you used to pick it by hand.
We picked it by hand, and we were picking cotton, and she was on up the row. Ahead of me, I didn't know who she was at that time.
Yeah.
Well, I had to find out, so I just peeled back one of those cotton bolts that hadn't yet opened.
Right.
And I let go. And we got acquainted pretty quick.
Hit her about
Yeah. Right there.
Near El Paso, just near the.
Where she was bent over.
That's right. And you said you did it to get her attention, and you said?
And I said he's had it ever since.
That's right. You're 58 years
old. He took me for better or worse, but I'm worse than he took me for.
Oh, get out of here. Look there, honey, right here. How you doing, Angel?
Fine.
Who you got here?
I have with me my sister, Pam.
Hello, Pam.
My sister Peggy.
Hi, Richard.
My sister Penny.
Hello.
Hi.
And my sister Polly.
Hi, Polly.
Hi.
How old is Polly?
Polly is 14.
Where do you live?
We're originally from Yorba Linda.
Where do you live now?
Right now, I live in Lake Forest, California.
Ready to play this game?
We sure are.
All righty, come on, Bert. Right up. Yeah. 100 people surveyed, top 6 answers on the board. You got to try and get the most popular answer. Here's the question. Name an item teenagers shoplift. Bert.
Jewelry.
Two answers would be the Patty.
Clothes.
Clothes. All right. Yeah, but you got it. You're going to play a pass.
Play.
Yeah, you're going to play. What happened? Where did this come from?
I got won that in a hog calling contest, believe it or not.
You won this?
I did, but don't ask me to do it again.
No. That's when you say suey, is it?
Yeah, that's something like that.
They're kind of cute. And
she says that's her good luck charm.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's my good luck piece. These hogs are going to stay.
Well, no, she doesn't want to do it. She's saving it for next year. Mm-hmm. How are you doing, Trent?
I'm doing pretty good.
Good, good. We want an item that teenagers shoplift.
Well, I've seen them trying to get candy bars.
Yeah? You never did that when you were a boy?
Oh, no. I live too far out in the country.
Gotcha. You were too busy heaving cotton balls.
Right.
Candy bar! Yeah. You did okay there, Travis.
Right.
Hi.
How are you?
Pretty good.
Good. What do you say?
Well, I'm going to say cigarettes.
Say it then.
Cigarettes.
Okay. Cigarettes! You're looking even more beautiful.
Oh, thank you.
Sure.
Like you're a sweet talker.
What do you say? You sweet talker, you. Something teenagers shoplift.
Makeup.
Makeup, all right.
Good answer. Good answer.
Do they take makeup? Yes, she was pretty good there. There's just one answer left. No strikes, so you're okay. Something the teenager shoplift. You can
furniture.
See he's honest, wow. Can't you? Because he's got no idea. And what'd you say?
I don't know. Blankets, small appliances, like that.
There's just gonna be one answer. Just say one thing.
Blankets.
Blankets?
Yeah.
That's good.
I can't think of anything.
Just sort of, just put them in your windbreaker. Are you stealing a blanket or are you Dolly Parton?
My head is
no, no, listen, I can tell that you're not a shoplifter, so that's not.
No.
If you are, you're a hopeless one. Blanket? Nope. You gonna polish it off, Bert? Something teenagers shoplift.
I hope so. Now, let's see, I'd think they would shoplift money.
Money?
Yeah.
Go to the money store and steal it. Now, when we get in here, I'll sidle up to the $20 counter. Money? Nope. It's up to Travis. Travis, are you going to do this first now?
Oh, yeah, I think they might pick up pencils or pens.
These are goodies, eh? The kids do
that.
I'm going to check with the police department. I think you got a record as a young man. Pencils, if it's there, you got it all. If not, get ready to steal. Pencil? No, not there.
All right.
$83 can be yours, Patty.
Records.
Well?
We're going to say records.
Records. All right, Paula. If it's there, you get the $83. If not, Bert gets it. Record? She said records and tapes. She said records and tape.
She said records
yeah,
and tape.
Yeah, yeah, surely. Yeah, all right, you got $83. See how it works? We'll be back right after this. We'll be right back. $83 there. Nothing there, but Travis is coming up here. And Miss Travis.
How you doing?
I'm fine.
Okay. Everything all right, champ?
Okay with me.
Okay. 100 people surveyed. Top five answers on the board. Here's the question. Name the one aspect of your job that makes you stay there. Yes, sir.
Well, it's necessary to have the money.
The money. The money? What are you going to do? What are you going to do? Play or pass?
Play.
We're going to play.
We come to play.
You came to play. Well done, Travis. Don't get smart with me now. You got to play. We came to play. One aspect of your job that makes you stay there.
Well, I'm not sure what word to use, but I want to say enjoyment, satisfaction from your
nothing
job.
Nothing wrong with that at all. You enjoy your
good
job.
Answer. Right.
You enjoy it. You don't have a job, do you, Tom?
No, I don't. School, if you call that a job.
But I mean, if you had one, what do you think it might be?
Friends.
The friends you got?
Good friends.
All right.
Good
friends. Friends! You heard that. Well, an aspect of your job that makes you stay there, I guess your answer's going to be blanket, isn't it?
Wouldn't be for to help people. That'd be enjoyment.
I guess that would be enjoyment, yeah, of your job. Okay. Don't look so worried now. It's just a game, you know. If you had a job, what would make you want to stay there? What sort of things? Three seconds. You're going to give me a smile because I'm not going to move later. Come on now. This is just a... Don't worry about it. Travis doesn't worry, do you, Travis?
No. Not much.
That's because he's sauced all the time.
Yeah.
One aspect of your job that makes you stay there.
I'm a retired nurse, and I would say advancement.
Okay. Good chance of advancement. Nope, not that. That's right. Travis, one aspect of your job that makes you stay there.
My boss shows confidence in me.
Oh, okay. All righty. If that's there, you're all right. If not, third strike. Confidence? No.
All right, come on.
Ladies.
Benefits.
Benefits.
Vacation.
Well.
We're going to say the benefits.
The benefits. All right. If it's there, you take all the money. If not, Bert gets $67. The benefits. Yes. Number five. Yeah, that means you get to meet some seniors, like Travis. We'll be back right after that. Challengers have all the money, $150. Nothing there. Let's go, let's go. How are you?
Fine.
Little cutie pie. 300 is the magic score we're looking for. First family to get that, we'll play for $5,000. Dollar values are doubled. 100 people surveyed. Top seven answers on the board. Here's the question. Name a children's story with an animal in the title.
I can't think. Oh.
Children's story with an animal in the title.
I was a kid. I've got one.
You seem to have it covered then.
Oh.
3 seconds.
I can't think. Oh.
Okay, come on.
No problem if it's the first one. Okay.
How about Bambi?
Bambi? All right. Is it there, Bambi?
All right.
Bambi's always there. Okay.
I don't know if this is a story, but Mary Had a Little Lamb. I know it's a song, but I don't know if it's a story.
Kind of nice, isn't it? Mary had a little lamb. It weighed 8 pounds, 4 ounces. Mary had a little lamb. Oh. I think that's a nursery rhyme, I think.
Oh, okay.
Father Goose? Children's story? Random on the title. 3 seconds.
Oh, shoot. I can't think of
it. Chance for you to get in the game. If you give me one, you stay in the game with $160. A children's story with an animal in the title. Come on, I need an answer because the buzzer
Donald Duck.
Donald Duck? Donald Duck? Donald Duck is there. You get the money. If not, you're the champ. It's Donald Duck. Didn't somebody say Black Beauty here? Donald Duck is a cartoon character. Four. Peter Rabbit. Five.
Chicken Little.
Seven. Ugly Duckling. Well, the Black Beauty wasn't there anyway, but I certainly would have said Black Beauty before. There's no money there, darling, but you got $1,004. We got nice prizes for you.
Thank you.
Did you have a good time?
Thank you.
Have a safe journey home. Good darling. Thank you, girl. Bye,
thank you.
Bye, pretty.
Thank you.
Bye. Who's going to play? Come on, let's go. Who's first? Pam and Patty going for the money right after we watch this. Well done.
The top answer is on the board. See if you got it when we return.
Two Whopper Juniors for just $5. Six options, so much to offer. Barbecue, bacon, cheese to name a few. Only $5 and you get to pick two. BK, have it your way.
Ever wonder why Kit Kats are so delightfully crispy? There's your answer. 1, 2, 3. Tasty wafers covered in creamy milk chocolate. Isn't it nice wafers are having their moment? Have a break. Have a Kit Kat. Add mint to the moment with Mint Duos.
Hey! Oh, this is my turn!
You can now have Domino's dropped to a location near you with new Domino's Pinpoint Delivery. Just choose Pinpoint Delivery on the Domino's app, drop a pin on the map, and get pizza delivered just about anywhere.
Here you are.
Thank you. It's Domino's Pinpoint Delivery.
Some ale's on me.
Whoa!
Your cousin from Boston.
Whose pool is this anyway?
Yeah!
None of us know?
Sam Adams Summer Ale. Light and citrusy. Perfect for summer.
At Olive Garden, our cheese will make you melt and leave you bubbling with joy. Best part is, it keeps coming till you say when. Olive Garden, we're all family here.
At Dots, an ordinary pretzel just isn't enough. So they add savory seasoning and tempting buttery flavor into every delicious twist. Now that's enough to make you build an all-pretzel pantry with a biometric security system. Dots, sensationally seasoned pretzels.
These Reese's Cups are now filled with Reese's Puffs, which begs the question, how much Reese's is too much Reese's? But who's begging that question? Try Big Cups. They're stuffed with more stuff.
Okay. 15 seconds, please. Name the room in the house that's always the messiest.
The kitchen.
Something that revolves.
A merry-go-round.
An occasion to send flowers.
Birthday.
Something you find at a picnic.
Ants.
Something banks lend people money to buy.
Cars.
Very good. What room in the house is always the messiest, you said? Kitchen survey said 30. Something that revolves. Merry-go-round. Survey said 12. An occasion to send flowers, you said a birthday. Everybody said 24. Something you find at a picnic, you said uncles. Aunts, I'm sorry. Survey said 40. Country, banks, land, people, money, buy. You said cars. Survey said. They stand right next to Peggy. Bill Paris. You only need 40 points. 40 points, you got $5,000. Okay? Please remind everyone the answers Pam gave us. Give me 20 seconds on the clock. That was 22 seconds. Name the room in the house is always the messiest.
Kitchen.
Try again.
Bedroom.
Something that revolves.
A lazy Susan.
An occasion to send flowers.
Baby birth.
Try again.
Wedding.
Something you find at a picnic.
Ants.
Try again.
Paper plates.
Something banks lend people money to buy.
Car.
Try again.
House.
House. Turn around. You want a room in the house, always the messiest. You said? Bedroom. You need 40 points for the money. Survey said? Bedroom number one. Something that revolves. You said a lazy Susan. Survey said? Two. Revolving door. Number one answer. An occasion to send flowers, you said?
Dumb.
A wedding. That's good, you send flowers. Need 3 points for the money. Survey said?
Family Feud Classic presents Huddle Talk.
All right, we'll pass it.
Okay, one back there. Talk it over.
Let's pretend like we're talking.
Is Richard's flower fake?
This carpet is filthy.
I'm hungry. When's lunch?
Grandpa, no napping.
Okay.
Broccoli.
Broccoli.
Stop saying broccoli. You're not the boss of me.
You need a breath mint.
I can't get up.
Join the conversation on Family Feud Classic. Watch now.
The strange thing is, the five girls don't know any of these other people. We'll see you here on The Feud. Bye-bye.
Some
departing contestants receive Dermassage dishwashing liquid, the only one with protein, actually improves dry, irritated, detergent hands. Better hands begin with Dermassage. Sparkling clean dishes, too. Step Saver, ideal for no-wax floors, too, because it cleans without dulling, shines without buildup. The Easy Driver, ratchet screwdriver, designed to fit your hand, easier to use. More than doubles your turning power, one great gift. 4 gallons of super scrubbable True Test Easy Care Latex Flat Wall and Trim Finish. Perfect for both walls and woodwork. Sold only by True Value Hardware Stores. This is Gene Woods speaking for Family Feud. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.